Well, Baltimore City is offering potential slots operators as many as 13 locations to choose from. Their goal is to entice high-quality bidders. The city is also demanding less rent from the casino and is slightly changing the math to lower property taxes. I-Team reporter David Collins live tonight with an update for us, David.
Well, Marianne, this is one of the available properties, and as you can see, it's just south of the stadium. The city lowered expectations, based in part on competition from slots at Arundel Mills Mall and on returns from the Perryville Casino. Now, as the city sweetened its deal to drum up more interest and bidding for a slots location here, a new legal twist has developed regarding a previous bidder. All 13 locations are clustered just south of M&T Bank Stadium. The biggest parcel, 4 acres on Austin Street, is available for parking or ancillary use only. It's not zoned for slots. Environmental work has not been completed. 7 of the 13 locations are small, individually much less than an acre. Potential bidders would have to consider buying several parcels in order to build what city officials hope will be a world-class casino entertainment complex that contains 3,750 machines. This would be the state's second largest casino. Mayor Stephanie Rollins Blake declined to discuss the city's latest proposal. Under the new terms, developers get to pay less rent than previously requested. Slots operators would pay $8 million the first year, $10 million the second, $12 million the third, $13 million the fourth, and $14 million from the fifth to the 50th year of business. The casino owner would be required to pay $3.2 million each year in property taxes on the site. Casino revenue will be used to help the city lower its property tax rates. At 2.27%, they're twice as high as neighboring jurisdictions. Once the parlor is up and running by late 2013, early 2014, the city expects slots revenues to reduce the property tax burden by 30.3 cents within 5 years.
What do you have here?
Until now, the city slot site had been on legal hold. Canadian Michael Maldenauer, the sole bidder who lost his opportunity because of a lack of funds, has withdrawn his request for a temporary restraining order and preliminary injunction. He wanted to prevent the city from soliciting bids until his appeal of a February court ruling that he had no claim to the property was heard. He's now asking for a refund of the $3 million licensing fee. But this has created a new legal twist. Is the money a Maldenhauer's, or did someone lend it to him? The Maryland Lottery has filed what's called an interpleader with Circuit Court to determine the rightful owner. No word on when the circuit court will rule. However, its decision will have no bearing on new bids, which are due July 28th. Reporting live from South Baltimore, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.